Hello everyone, welcome to CAD CAM tutorial. In this video we are going to create core and cavity for a simple pattern. Here you can see that this is a simple pattern for which we want to make core and cavity. This is the core, this is the cavity, and here it is the parting surface, and here you can see the entire mold box. So let's begin it. Now before making the core and cavity for a pattern, first we'll create one working directory so that all the parts that we'll create will be in a single folder. So we'll go for select working directory, select your desktop, right click and select your new folder, and we'll name it as a mold, and okay. Now first we'll create our pattern. So we'll go for a new part, select your part, uncheck here use default templates, and okay. And here we'll select solid part millimeter kg second, and okay. Now first we'll go for sketch, and we'll select here this top plane, sketch and sketch view. Now here we'll draw one rectangle using the center rectangle like this. Now this side is of 300 mm and this vertical one is of 200. Now here we have to give the fillet, so we'll go for fillet and select all the sides one by one like this. Now the fillet radius is 20 mm, so enter 20. Now sketch is completed, so we'll exit the sketch. We'll go for extrude and enter depth as 50 mm. Okay. Now here we'll select shading with edges. Now here we have to give the fillet, so we'll go for round. Enter radius as 10 mm, and then select here this upper edge. Okay. Now we have to create hollow pattern, and for that purpose we'll go for shell. Enter thickness as 4 mm, and then select here this lower face. Okay. Now our pattern is completed, and we'll get appearance. So we'll select here entire part, go for the view, appearance, and select here this red color. Now we'll save it, so we'll go for file, save as, and we'll name it as pattern, and okay. Now after creating pattern, we have to create the mold box. So we'll go for file, new, and select here manufacturing, and in manufacturing we'll select here mold cavity. Now here uncheck use default templates, and okay. And select here millimeter newton second manufacturing mold. Okay. Now first we have to import our pattern, so we'll go for reference model, select here pattern and open. Now here we want to import same model, so click on same model. Okay, and done. Now here you can see that by default it shows this direction as our pull direction, but we know that when we'll create core and cavity for this particular pattern, then this would be our pull direction. So first we have to alter the pull direction. So for that we'll go for pull direction, and here this will be our pull direction. So select here this face, and okay. And you can see that we have altered the pull direction. Now after altering the pull direction, we have to create the mold box, and for that purpose we'll go for workpiece, and here we'll create workpiece. Now here we'll go for part, and we want to create solid part. Now for file name, we'll give name as mold box, and okay. And here we'll create mold box with using the different features. So select here create feature, and okay. Now first we'll go for sketch, and we'll select here this face, sketch and sketch view. Now for the reference, we'll give this plane and this plane as reference, and close it. Now here for making the mold box, we'll create one rectangle. So we'll go for center rectangle and draw one rectangle like this. Now, as you know that the mold box will be bigger than the pattern, so the dimensions will be 340 and 240. Now we'll exit the sketch, then we'll go for extrude. Now in this direction we'll extrude it for 50 mm. Then we'll go for options, and inside too we'll extrude it for 100 mm, and okay. Now after creating the mold box, we have to divide mold box into two parts, that is core and cavity. So before that, right click on assembly and make it activate. Now here you can see that this is our entire mold box, and inside that there is our pattern. Now before dividing the mold box into two parts, we have to create one parting surface, and that parting surface is with respect to our pattern. So first right click on mold box and we'll make it hide. Then we'll go for parting surface, select here fill, and then we'll select here this face. Then we'll go for sketch view. Now we know that parting surface should be bigger than the mold box, so we'll go for circle and we'll draw one circle like this, and the circle should be outside this mold box, so it is like this, and let us give diameter as 480. Now we know that parting surface divide entire mold into two part, that is core and cavity. So here we know that this is our entire mold, and from that the lower portion will be core, upper portion will be cavity, and we know that the core portion should include the inner portion of this pattern, and for that purpose we have to exclude this part from the parting surface. And for that we'll go for project, select here chain, and we'll select here this inner portion or this inner edge, and click on OK, accept, OK, and we'll close it. So here this should be our parting surface, and click on OK, OK, and OK. Now we have created our parting surface, so that entire mold box will be divided from this parting surface and here from this inner surface. Now after that we'll right click on mold box and we'll make it show. Now we have to divide entire volume into two part, and before that we'll go for reference part cutout and select here entire mold box, OK. Then we'll go for mold volume, select here volume split. Now first we have to select entire mold box, and here we have to select here this parting surface, and OK. Now after that we'll go for mold component, and here you can see that there are two volumes created, one is core, another is cavity. So we'll select both, OK. Now we have created core and cavity for this pattern, and then we'll go for view, select here edit position. Now select here this upper part and just drag it like this, select here this lower part and drag it like this, and here this entire mold box. And then click on OK. Now these are our core and cavity. We'll go for view, appearance, and select here this yellow color. Again we'll select here this face, go for appearance, and select here this blue color. And here also we'll select here this face and appearance. So here you can see that we have created core and cavity for this simple pattern, and we'll hide all this. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you like this video, then please hit on the like button, share it, and subscribe to this channel, CADCAM CE Tutorials. Thanks.